my monster from his lab began to rise. And suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast. The ghouls all came from their humble abode to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash. The zombies were having fun. The party had just begun. The guests included Wolfman, Dracula, and his son. The scene was rocking, all were digging the sounds. Igor on chains, backed by his baying hounds. The con-
Hey, Drew!
Drew!
Drew! Get out of here! Oh, you're on.
You're on, Hugh!
Woo! Sorry, guys, we had a little interruption.
Hugh, it's makeup time. Hey, is that it? You're sweating, buddy.
I'm sweating. Woo! Welcome back, guys. Cooking at Crest. With my good buddy, Mike Brosin.
That's right. We're ready to go.
It's Halloween. I see you're all dressed up.
I'm dressed up like a cowboy because I'm about the only cowboy around because the dadgum Dallas Cowboys haven't shown up.
Well, amen to that.
That's what I'm saying. Ooh, but anyway, man. That's a whole different story.
Whole different story. All right, guys. Today we have this beautiful sticky chicken with a latska curry. It's a Thai-style curry, right?
And it's awesome.
Coconut cream. This is an awesome recipe. You can make it in about 15, 20 minutes.
Super quick. So we'll get started.
Let's get started.
So we're going to take the chicken.
Yep, so we start with a little boneless, skinless chicken thighs.
Yep. And
My favorite kind of meat.
Yeah, exactly.
Love that dark meat.
We're going to pat it up here with a little bit of your special spice that
you made up.
Asian five spice.
Woo! A little salt and pepper on that too.
Yep, a little salt and pepper. And take this baby over a little bit like this. And
fold it over.
Fold it over.
Give it a little roly roll.
Just a little. Don't beat it too much. And then
don't beat it like it owes you money.
Nope, beat it like it owes you money. All right, and then you're going to...
And then waiting for the pan to get hot, let's go ahead and make our curry paste.
Okay.
So slide that food processor over.
Yep.
Get that on camera.
This is the fun part.
This is the fun part. This is where all the magic happens, guys. Okay, so we got our ginger.
So
throw that in there.
Got the ginger. Yeah.
Boom.
Here we go.
Garlic.
Garlic.
I know the recipe calls for like three, but we're going to put it all in.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. That is some homemade peanut butter.
Yes. Awesome.
So we made it ourselves here. I said, well, why buy it when I have peanuts? I might as well just make it. Oh, that always tastes better. Everything homemade, guys. Always. And then we're going to put our turmeric.
Yep, our turmeric. Boy, I tell you, that's good.
Ooh, it's good stuff.
Great flavor there.
I tell you what, you better have a separate bowl if you're making this at home. That stuff stains everything.
Don't want that to be in something that you're going to try to use again because it will stain it.
It will stain. And let's put some beautiful local honey from Anna, Texas.
Anna, Texas.
Good for your allergies, you know. Got to keep it local.
Oh, yeah.
Put that in there. And we're going to dump the cilantro.
Oh, yeah. Cilantro's going to be great.
All of that in there. Oh, yeah. And then we found some latska curry paste. L-A-S-K-A, Laska.
We're going to use about half that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like it spicy. So this is pretty much pureed shallots, lemongrass, coffee or lime leaf.
Yeah.
Coriander, all sorts of good stuff.
Okay.
We're just going to put the lid on that.
Yep.
Here it is right there.
Do a little pulse on it, right?
Yep. Get this thing going.
Yeah.
Boom. Now, if you guys don't have a big food processor like this at home, you can use a smaller one. It will work, I promise. Look at that. That is looking good. Nice and chunky still.
Man,
let me get a pair of tongs out of here.
You guys got to look this. Look how good that turned out.
They just really good flavor.
Good flavor. Man, smelling it.
Yeah. The whole thing smells great. Oh, great, great aroma.
So we're going to start with our chicken here. I got this beautiful grill pan.
Oh, yeah.
This is going to be so good. So I've made this recipe a couple times and always make it for the kids.
Yeah.
Not my kids are your age, right? So they come over, we knock this thing out, and it's a great, great dinner to make when you're not having a lot of time because it's like 15, 20, 25
Boom.
Minutes max.
Boom.
And it's easy to clean up.
You're not easy to clean up.
All right, guys, so we're going to start. Oh, look at that spare. I got purple. I went a little crazy and got a little purple spare.
Yeah, you got the purple asparagus. What's the deal?
I thought it would be more festive for Halloween. We got orange pumpkins and purple asparagus. I was just trying to get crazy with it, you know?
Okay, so we're going to put this in the broth.
Yeah, so we're going to get that going.
Right.
I'm going to get this pan nice and hot.
So what I'm going to do with this asparagus is you don't want to really chop it up too fine. You probably just want the, in my opinion, I like the kind of rough chop, a little bit bigger. Gives it a lot more texture. And I think it's...
That's going to be good.
Man, it
see,
is
still got
really
some green in there.
Oh, yeah. It's got a little bit going.
A little bit. That's it. Yeah. The rest of that, trash. Boom. Man, you made all that.
I made them all.
All right, guys. So we got our pan getting hot. We took our spaghetti squash and grated it into some nice, beautiful noodles. This allows us to cook it real fast and not have to wait.
Right.
Because,
right,
you know, that squash can really take a long time. So we have a half the squash there. We'll get that going. You can hear it sizzling up a little bit.
Man, beautiful. Look at that. The smell is outstanding.
Man, that smells so good.
It really does.
Let's go ahead and get that going up in
ready
here.
Ready to get it in?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Go ahead and knock it out.
Let's get it on, guys. Look at this. Look at that beautiful chunky. It's gonna be awesome.
Yeah.
Tons of flavor. Let's get that in there. Now, when you're making curries, you wanna put the curry in and toast it before you put your liquids in. That's where you get that beautiful nutty flavor. It's from toasting up that curry paste. So anytime you're making a good curry, this is a key step. Just get that up in there. Woo!
You want to throw a little bit of this lime on here?
Yeah, let's do that. I think I got some fresh bay leaves out of our garden.
You did.
Here at Crest. Look at that, a little
bay
leaves.
And we want to hit it with that.
Let's hit it with a little coconut milk.
Right.
Right there.
And also, we got chicken stock.
We got chicken stock hot right there.
Here we go.
So let's pour that coconut milk in.
Woo!
That's one whole can of coconut milk. We use the light. Gotta watch your calories.
Yeah, you know how great this is gonna taste.
So this dish is all, this whole thing, I even went and got gluten-free soy sauce.
Right.
So we're eating a gluten-free meal here, making sure, you know, we're getting into that winter bod. Summer bod's long
right,
gone.
That's all winter bod.
So while we're waiting for that to get all, man, see, it's looking good, huh?
It's looking so good. Man. Look how that's just coming to life. The just the way
cilantro.
It looks, it looks like a great soup. Take a hard look at this.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Look at that. Look at that five.
Oh, chicken, yeah. That chicken's getting it on.
Let's throw some red chilies on top of that.
Oh, yeah.
And then
go ahead.
Let's get it. Let's go. Get that in there.
Where's
the sizzled up?
Okay, that extra honey. We need that extra honey.
We need
that
extra honey. Give
extra
me one
honey. We need a little honey to throw on the chicken because we're gonna hit the chicken.
Fresh local honey, baby.
Right. So we're gonna hit that chicken and watch this. Man, this is such a good.
This is what makes it sticky, guys.
All right, take a look at this.
Sesame seed.
Man, you want?
Don't even be scared.
Look, they're gonna be toasted up and tasting. The aroma and the taste of that is so good.
Look at that.
Yeah.
You think a little more chicken stock?
Yeah, I think so.
We're gonna put the noodles in.
We're gonna put those noodles in, and that'll soak up some of the stock.
Let's just do it all. Why not all? I mean, what would that be in shy for?
That's what I'm saying.
Trust your instincts. Trust your instincts.
So let's tell them about how this is gonna happen. So these glass noodles, we're gonna put them in, and put them in there, in the broth. So we're not going to mess with, you know, boiling them in water and then put them in. You just put them right in and let them go. So I think we'll do it right now.
Let's do it.
Knock it out.
I don't think we're going to fit all of it in
no,
there.
No.
We'll just do that right
one,
there.
Yeah. Woo. I might get a little half here.
A little half?
Yeah.
Perfect. Get it on.
Yeah.
Now these can take a couple minutes to cook, guys. When this is nice and hot.
Flavors are going to be outstanding.
Man, smell that, honey.
Look at this. Look at this chicken. Just look how it is coming to life.
Woo.
And I mean, it is going to be so good.
Look at that, guys. Look at that. Mm. Man, I smell that honey.
Isn't that awesome?
This is going to be so good. I'm going to have to go home and make this tonight for my wife. She would really appreciate this. We love coconut soup.
Oh, yeah.
One of my favorite things to make.
Well, I know it's good if my wife eats it because she's not a big fan of that milky type of base.
Well, it's dairy-free.
Yeah.
It's different, you know? This is good stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, what do we got going on at Crest this week?
Man, we got all kinds of stuff going on at Crest. Hey, by the way, just in case you want to buy a car and not cook something and eat, we have our new 2021 Escalade in. You got to come by and take a look at it.
It's insane.
Yeah, it's an unbelievable vehicle. It's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful vehicle. And so we have a couple that might not be spoken for, but you don't know by the end of the day. But we've had, I think, 35 of them come in. And all 35 have sold within an hour.
An hour.
Most of them were already pre-sold anyway. So
there you go.
Yeah, it's been great. And the product is outstanding right now. Cadillac is really hitting it up. I mean, they're doing a big job. Infiniti's got some super smoking car deals out there. If you want to buy a car.
It's the time. Yeah. My wife just bought a car yesterday.
Oh, yeah. That's right. She did.
She just bought
Becky. It. Becky just bought that. That's right.
So, I mean, if the chef's buying cars, you know they're crazy deals because I'm cheap.
Yeah, he ain't that cheap. Hey, and Volvo is, I mean, just on fire. It's such an outstanding product right now. And, Duncan McPhail and his, you know, team. And, man, I'm telling you, they're all doing a great job over there as well. So come by and see us and see what you think because it's definitely worth it.
I'll tell you what, if you guys come dressed up in your costume tomorrow, I'll buy you lunch.
All right. Yeah. I thought you were going to, like, give him a car or something.
No, you come in, I'll buy you a steak lunch.
Right.
And all right. You come dressed up in your costume.
All right, now we're going to hit
boiling
it.
Up.
We're going to hit it with the asparagus, the purple asparagus.
See, that's good looking.
That actually does look good. I used green asparagus in mine. And when we plate this up, I'm telling you, you're going to really enjoy it. You got those two bowls right there?
Yeah. Almost there.
Yeah.
Delicious.
I wish you could just smell it. The smell is unbelievable, you know?
Man, look, guys.
Yeah. So you want to put that right here, take that chicken, we'll put it right here. And
slice that up.
Oh, yeah.
Woo! Look at that, baby.
Yeah.
That's going to be hot.
Yeah.
I want those tongs.
Right. So we're, oh man, huge.
Dude,
that chicken.
Come on.
Wow. You don't even need to slice it with a knife.
You can eat that with a fork.
That's the advantage of giving it
a little
tenderizing.
Love, a little bang,
you know. Yeah. A little tenderizing never hurt anybody.
Never. Man. All right, well, we're finishing up this soup, guys. We're going to use our gluten-free, low-sodium soy sauce. Just hit it with a little bit of that, right?
Oh, yeah.
And then one of my favorite underutilized ingredients is fish sauce. I think it's delicious.
Yeah, boy, I'm telling
underutilized. It gives such a dynamic flavor.
Tell them what it does for that. The flavor, what it does.
It just explodes with flavor after you add that in. I mean, look at that. Oh, the noodles are just there. They're ready to go.
Oh, yeah. Look at this thing, man. It's happening.
It's happening. Big time.
Yeah.
This is a great,
great dish.
You out trick-or-treating tomorrow. You come in. Your kids are hungry. You got 20 minutes before they lose their mind. I know my 2-year-old does.
Ahead.
You got to be on the go, ready with dinner.
It's going to be fun.
So we're going to plate this up, guys.
Okay. Here we go.
Yeah, here we go.
You going to go?
Yeah.
Okay.
You got it? Got it. Let's get it. I'll get the noodles. You finish with the other.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
of that, guys. Oh, man.
It smells outstanding.
Dude.
I'm digging that.
This is insane. Look at that.
And now
let's get that broth. Let's hit it with that broth and that. Look at that. It doesn't get any more festive than that, guys.
Man, that is Halloween. I mean, you should smell
that. Purple and orange.
Purple
Halloween.
And orange is so good.
Oh, that's cilantro in there. Look at that.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Now,
throw that chicken on there.
Do this chicken.
Woo.
Woo. Get it with the
little red jalapeno.
Yeah.
Let's do some fresh scallions.
Yeah.
A little coffee or lime wedge.
Check this out.
Guys, this is,
man,
one of the most beautiful dishes. Look at that. Oh, yeah.
I mean, this is unbelievable. This lime, you want to squeeze on yours.
Yeah.
This lime gives it such an outstanding flavor.
That's a juicy lime. Watch out.
Money shot.
Dang, guys.
Yeah.
You gotta get better than this.
Yeah.
Are we having fun?
Come on, we wanna eat this right now. Let's go.
Let me get some utensils. Thanks for tuning in, guys.
Well, let's eat it in front of them.
Well,
come on. Hell, I wanna make sure they know that we're cooking some food that we eat. Of course, I will say this. That looks pretty dang good. Might need to take a picture of that.
Oh, yeah,
I did.
Boom. Man, I smell that lime.
Yeah.
Mm.
Oh,
man.
That is stinking good.
Woo!
Wow.
That is awesome. Oh,
yeah.
I gotta try the chicken. That's what I'm looking forward to. Look at that.
Man.
Mmm. That caramelized honey on there.
I told you that, didn't that?
That's the secret right there, is that caramelized honey.
That's a little bro extra. That recipe didn't call for that. So.
A little audible.
Mmm. Mmm.
Dang.
Holy smoke. That's great. Hey, guys. Thanks for tuning in. We appreciate it. Come see Chef Hugh. Come see Crest. And have a safe Halloween.
Yep.
And take care. Thank you.
Take care. Thank you very much. Y'all have a great weekend.
It caught on in a flash.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash. Out from his coffin, Rex's voice did ring. Seemed he was troubled by just one thing. Opened the lid and shook his fist and said, whatever happened to my Transylvania twist?
It's now the mash.
It's now the monster mash.
The monster mash.
And it's a graveyard smash.
It's now the mash.
It's caught on.